Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to, and if you're joining us from the beginning, the Dawah Conference of ICNA. So my name is Yasser Aslam, here from the Gain Peace office in Chicago. So without further ado, I do want to let you know for this program, the title of it is Dawah Reimagined. Ali Dawah is joining us from the UK.
I've been here waiting for you guys.
Oh, you're here. Okay. We're just waiting for you in the chat. Now, this is my first time interacting with Brother Ali. Assalamu alaikum, Brother Ali. How are you?
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you? Are you all right?
I'm doing good. You're across the pond. Alhamdulillah. So glad for us to join us. And alhamdulillah, I know you're a very humble brother. And I know from the bio that we had, putting it together, was just Ali Dawah is a content creator on YouTube whose videos help spread the message of Islam and inspire youth. He is also the co-founder of Islam Initiative, the Salam Initiative in the UK. So, you know, Assalamu alaikum from Chicago. How are you doing?
Wa alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How's the weather?
All right, Brother Ali, the floor is all yours, and I will see you guys in a little bit. Assalamu alaikum.
Ask them about the weather, guys, but, you know, I think I'm going to get someone else to tell me about the weather in Chicago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Are you there? How was the weather?
Alhamdulillah. Yes, I'm back, alhamdulillah. But yes, how's the weather? What time is it right now in the UK?
Here, it's 8:45 p.m.
Okay, so it's nighttime. All right. For here in Chicago in Central Standard Time, it's 2:45 or so. It's 3:45, I believe.
Is it hot?
Say that again?
They're hot.
Oh, it's hot? The weather is nice. Cannot complain.
Very cold. We're freezing. Cold.
It's cold? Oh, that's why you're wearing purple. Okay.
Anyway, I'll get on to it, inshallah.
All right, I'll leave you to your session, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Okay, barakallahu feek. Okay, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Hope you guys are well, inshallah. Before I start, I want to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the most just. All praises, glory, and gratitude belong to Him. I thank ICNA for inviting me. It's a pleasure to be on here and give my two pence peace, inshallah. I want to start off with something that's very important to our organization. As you can see behind me, sharing, affection, love for L, and mercy. So we derive this from a hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the Prophet said that I did not come for nothing, for anything, except to perfect good manners. And to share affection, love, and mercy is things that people have to see. Yes, you can speak the love of the language of love or mercy or compassion, affectionate, yes, but also to demonstrate that, to show that on the front lines, on the ground level, is very, very important. And a lot of the times, people in the dawah, they do not give importance to character and adab. And this goes for me as well. I have shortfall times where I look and be like, Ali, did you represent yourself the best way? No, you didn't. And they say, for example, a picture speaks 1,000 words. Actions speak louder than words. So brothers and sisters, what we understand from this is that one's character, a person analyzes you. You can be somebody like Brother Zaki Naik, may Allah bless him and preserve him, that can quote Bible and Quran verses like this, and you can impress people, and that might be amazing and good. But if you have bad character, if you're arrogant, if you convey yourself in the ground level, because I just came back from Speaker's Corner. As you can see, my t-shirt here. There you go. I just came back from Speaker's Corner. Alhamdulillah. And a lot of people might be thinking, Brother Ali, you've got a big subscriber base. You don't even need to go to the park anymore. Why do you find the need to go there? And it's very important, because the prophets and many of the Anbiya, they engage with people on a ground level. They didn't say, oh, I'm a prophet. You know, I'm a prophet. Oh, I don't need to go there. Yes, there was times where Prophet, peace be upon him, sent Muad ibn Jabal to Yemen. And these were missions that was done. But it's very important for us to dialogue with the people on the ground level. Let's see where people are at. Let's see where their concerns are. Speaking to them, understanding, having empathy, relating with them, talking to them, finding out what the problem is. We speak to a lot of youngsters. So we have Salam Corner in Speaker's Corner. And the reason we started Salam Corner is because Speaker's Corner is known for its sadly aggressive, ego-filled, righteous attitude of winning over each other, etc. So we thought we want to move away from that. We want to have a simple discussions and dialogues as a team, to dialogue with people and understand them on a human level. And this is done with one's character and adab, how they carry themselves. It is fundamental for us to understand the importance of this, because people will, they might, for example, some say, okay, you know, when you make a mistake to someone and you ask for an apology, yes, but that person may forgive you, but they will never forget how you made them feel. And that's why, for example, one of the scholars in Egypt, I can't remember who it was, I watched a video and he said, he was asking Nasiha to Sheikh Salah Al-Fawzan, if I'm not mistaken, and he was saying, what advice would you give me? Like, I'm good, like, in my dawah. He said, I'll give you two advice. Number one, may Allah make you beneficial to the people. Number two, when you're giving dawah, if the person opposite you is not accepting your message or has a problem, at least leave him neutral, meaning do not make him an enemy. Don't say, oh, look at you, you're an arrogant guy, you don't want to accept it, Islam is the truth. You know, your attitude should not be like that. Leave people balanced. At least they are left with something positive, something that you've left them. If they haven't accepted Islam, you've left them neutral. And it's very important for us to do this, for us to, when we're conveying the message, like Allah says in the Quran to the Prophet, peace be upon him, that indeed if you was harsh, they would have fled from you, they would have run away from you. And what do we understand from that, brothers and sisters, in today's time, is that when we're dialoguing with people, is for us to, subhanAllah, the way we carry ourselves, let people see Tawheed, let people see Islam in your actions. We have worked with a lot of people in the past, and I work and I speak to a lot of people, and they say, oh, you know, this brother, he doesn't call to Tawheed, he doesn't call to, and I said, brother, what do you mean by call to Tawheed? Can you and make me understand that? And he'll say, you know, Aki, how many times did, you know, he talks about Tawheed al-Shirk? I said, yeah, Aki, can you call to Tawheed without using the word Tawheed? And can you do that? Is there a possibility? Yeah. So why is it that sadly we live in times that are materialistic, aesthetics? It's all about the outer. It's all about the outer. And we give so much emphasis to the outer that we think that somebody with books behind him and using a few Arabic terminologies like shirk or bidah or tawheed or this or that, and we think, wow, subhanAllah, this guy is someone of that calls to the sunnah, this is someone, you know, that calls to tawheed. Sadly, we have brought our religion to such a low level that we think individuals that look the part or talk the part, you know, play a role in the actual thing that they're trying to call to. That is not true, because a lot of people, brothers and sisters, have arrogant attitudes. They are arrogant. Iblis, why did Iblis lose his way? He was a righteous person. He worshipped Allah everywhere. He was knowledgeable. What caused him to lose? Why? Because he was arrogant. I am better than him. SubhanAllah, this arrogant attitude caused him to lose his way. So that's the reason why we can convey the message of Tawheed with our adab, our character, empathy, compassion. When we show this to people and people say, hold on a second, man, this is Islam is saying, you know, like a minute ago I was watching something in Fox 59 News, where that was, that they are saying that the Prophet did this and did that, all these lies. SubhanAllah, imagine if you have a good relationship and a lot of sisters and brothers come and say, how can I do dawah? Can I start a YouTube channel, etc.? I'm saying, no, you don't need to start a YouTube channel. Who said dawah is a YouTube channel, Instagram? What we're saying is the following, is that if you can just be kindness, your neighbors have rights. The Prophet said to us that angel Jibreel talked about the rights of the neighbor so much, the Prophet said, I fear that they're going to inherit from us. When is the last time we checked on our neighbor? This is ground level, on the ground. You want to do dawah. Dawah doesn't mean coming out and speaking fancy words. Doesn't mean, oh, look at me, I speak fancy words, oh, I'm so clever. No. When is the last time that you went and checked on your neighbor? When is the last time your elderly neighbor, you went and said, do you need help shopping? Do you have somebody cooking for you? Do you need help? When was the last time? When was the last time we did this? So much so that if you do this, wallahi, it will speak 1 million words that you can ever utter in your life. It will show that neighbor that when she opens the TV and says, Islam, terrorism, Islam, she'll say, one second, who do I know as a Muslim, my neighbor. What do I know of my neighbor? Nothing but goodness. That is the Islam that I know. The Islam that you're talking about, I'm free from that. When is the last time, brothers and sisters, we have done that? And us duat, yeah, I don't class myself as a duat. I'm just a passionate YouTuber who's a Muslim who tries to convey the message of Islam. Brothers and sisters, as duat, when was the last time? When was the last time we went and did ground level work behind the scenes? When was the last time we went and cooked for our neighbor who's elderly? When was the last time we went and shopped for them? When was the last time we went and helped our neighbor clean the roads or this, that? Yeah? What happens is we get caught up with thinking, yeah, I need to do this video and I need to have a debate with that person to show who I... SubhanAllah, that's good. But brothers and sisters, it's very important for us to fix what's internal. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in four places in the Quran, I'm not Zakir Naik, so I can't get the references. They're somewhere. But you can check this up, yeah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that Allah sent the clothing to cover our shame. So we wear clothing to cover our shame. And indeed, the clothing of taqwa is more important. Allah's mentioning that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that righteousness is not facing the east or the west. Yeah? Righteousness is not that you face the east or the west. If I'm not mistaken, it says that righteousness is that one has taqwa. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when you slaughter an animal, sacrifice an animal, it is not the blood or the flesh that reaches Allah, but it is what? The taqwa. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the Masjid Dirar. Yeah? And he talks about that the munafiqun were building a masjid. Why? They're building a masjid. Wow, amazing job. Wow, this that looks amazing. But they were doing it to divert people from the path of Islam. And Allah says that indeed, the masjid that is built upon taqwa is more deserving. Now let's put this into perspective. And I'm going to wrap up with this inshallah. Yeah? From the clothes you wear, to the direction you face, to the animal you slaughter, and to the place you worship Allah. Allah's talking about taqwa, 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 taqwa. Allah's not talking about your clothing, the animal that you sacrifice, the direction you face, and the place you pray. Allah's talking about taqwa, internal. So brothers and sisters, let's purify ourselves, our character, the way we carry ourselves, and let's get rid of this arrogant attitude that we have. And even today, some people, individuals have failed to, of, oh, you have to label yourself this. If you don't label yourself this, then you are not this. SubhanAllah. Yani the attitude that they have is that certain brothers, oh, is this brother this? Oh, is he from this group? Is he from that? SubhanAllah. They've busied themselves so much so that their hearts have become hardened, that they are so busy with other people. What's he doing? Oh, is he on the manhaj? Is he on this, on that? Brothers and sisters, wallahi, what a waste of time. Can you imagine spending your time, all you're doing is looking for other people's faults, mistakes. Where can I find them? So I, because I need to prove a point that I'm on the... SubhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, please, please, this is arrogance. Wallahi, you know what it reminds me of? You know these people who go around and check people like, do they belong to a certain group? It's as if Iblis is saying, is he made from fire like me? Smokeless fire. Is he made from fire? Is he not made from fire? Ah, you should know then. Arrogance. Wallahi, arrogance. So brothers and sisters, who's watching this, sisters and brothers, do your dawah. You can do dawah by your character, the way you carry yourself, helping your neighbors, your mom and dad. Wallahi, the way you treat your spouse in public, a wife, your wife or your husband. Wallahi, imagine someone looking and thinking, oh, these Muslim men, they treat their wives so badly. And you're there, subhanAllah. You know, just even like, wallahi, whatever, like stroking her hijab. Yani, I'm trying to teach some romantic romance to the brothers here. You know, it just simple stuff, holding her hand, showing her kindness, carrying the shopping, stuff like this. It will dismantle that, because they're going to think, subhanAllah, you know, look at that. So, brothers and sisters, I'll just wrap up that in that, inshallah. May Allah bless you guys. And I'm here, I think there's going to be a Q&A. So I'm here, inshallah. Just let me know whenever you guys want me to come.
That's fine. You have one more minute, inshallah. I'll let you finish up your point, brother Ali.
Again, I finished already.
We want to have the panel discussion with everyone too, so alhamdulillah.
Oh, no problem. Well, I'm finished.
Oh, you are?
Good timing. You came in good timing.
Oh, alhamdulillah. So, jazakum Allahu khairan, brother Ali.